Hi guys, welcome back. In today's video, I will show you how to install Android Studio on Windows 11 and set up the Android emulator so you can start building and testing Android apps, or you can simply explore Android without a physical device. It's super simple and I will guide you through it step by step. Let's get started. First, we need to download Android Studio. For that, open your browser and in the search bar, you need to type download Android Studio. On the search result, click on the official Android Studio download page, which is developer.android.com. Here, we need to download Android Studio, the official IDE, Integrated Development Environment for Android Apps Development. Okay, so just click on the download Android Studio Ladybug button. In this page, you need to scroll down and accept the terms and conditions by ticking the checkbox. Then click download Android Studio Ladybug 2024.2.1 patch to start the download. Okay. As you can see, the file size is around 1.1 GB, so it may take some time depending on your internet speed. Since I have already downloaded it earlier, I am going to cancel this download. Once the download is complete, the application file will look like this. Now we will install the software. Double click on this application file. A welcome setup wizard will open. Click next to continue. It will ask you to choose component. Keep the default option selected, that is Android Studio and Android Virtual Device AVD. Then click next. Here you choose an installation path. This is where the Android Studio IDE will be installed on your system. Okay. You can leave it as default. Click next again. Then click install. The installation process will start and you will see a progress bar. If you want to see what's being installed, just click on show details and it will show you the list of files being installed. This might take a few seconds, so just wait until it finishes. Okay. Once the installation is complete, you will see the message setup was completed successfully. Just click on next. At the bottom of the window, you will see a checkbox labeled Start Android Studio. Check this box and click on finish. After installation, Android Studio will guide you through an initial setup. During this process, it may ask you some questions to personalize your experience. When you open Android Studio for the first time, a window will pop up asking if you want to send user statistics to the Google to help improve Android Studio service. You need to simply click Don't Send to skip these steps. See, it will be finding the available SDK component. Okay. After the components download, you will see the Welcome to Android Studio screen. Click on Next. Here, you need to choose the type of setup you want. If you choose standard, it will be installed with the most common settings and it's also recommended for the new user. Okay. Then click next. Verify the settings and click next. In the setup wizard, you will be prompted to select the component to install. Review the license for each component, then tick the box to accept the terms. Finally, click finish to start the download. Now, you need to wait until the setup wizard downloads the required SDK files. This step might take anywhere from 10 to 20 minutes, depending on your internet speed. So make sure you have a stable internet connection and one thing, don't close the wizard during this process, okay? Once finished, you will see Android Virtual Device Medium Phone API 35 was successfully created. So you need to click on finish button. After the components download, you will see the Welcome to Android Studio screen. Click on More Action. Then select Virtual Device Manager. Once the AVD Manager page will open, you will see the virtual device you have created earlier. Okay. Now, let's create a new virtual device. So click on the plus icon at the top of the AVD Manager and select Create Virtual Device. From this page, you can choose any device from the available options. The categories are listed on the left pane. You can see there are phone, tablets, Wear OS, desktop and TV. Since we are creating a virtual phone, select phone from the category. Next, pick a phone model from the list. So here I'm going to choose Pixel 9 Pro, but you can pick any device you like. After selecting the phone, click on Next. On the next screen, select the desired system image and then click Next. In the final step, you will see the AVT, Android Virtual Device Configuration screen. Here you can change the name of the virtual device if you want, but I will leave it as Pixel 9 Pro API 35. Once done, click Finish. Now you will see your new virtual device in the AVT manager list. So select the virtual device from the list and click the start button, that is play icon over here, okay, and wait for a few seconds as the emulator boots up. You will see a emulator of Pixel 9 Pro will appear on the screen. Once the booting process is complete, your virtual Android phone emulator will be ready to use. You can now open apps like Google Play Store to install new apps, or you can also open YouTube to watch video. You can interact with the emulator using your mouse just like you would with a physical phone, okay. On the right side, there is a control bar with helpful tools. Okay, using this, you can rotate button to change the screen orientation from portrait to landscape. Use the power button to lock or unlock the emulator. To close the emulator, click on the cross icon at the top of the emulator window. Or you can also stop button from the device manager page. To start the emulator again, type Android Studio in your Windows search bar and open the application. Then go to the AVT manager and select the virtual device you want to use. Now click start to launch it, and your virtual phone will boot up fresh and ready for use. And that's it, you have successfully installed Android Studio on your Windows 11 PC and even launched your first mobile emulator. I hope this guide made things simple and clear for you guys. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon so you are the first to get updates on our latest tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.